This is the unboxing of a TV antenna, and you'll spend about 35 to 40 bucks on it. And you'll see right there, I start to unbox it, and this is the power supply. You're going to need that for inside the house that connects to a little device that controls the motor and the power amplifier as well. This box that I'm pulling out right here, let's see what's in there. My video is a little bit choppy as I go through this. Okay, so you have a, that's going to be the motor that goes outside. And that thing right there is going to hold your post or pole. And that is a the power device that's going to send a signal through the coax and also rotate the motor for your antenna. So, you know, once you're inside and you're trying to find the antenna strength, you'll hit your remote control. And that's how you do it. It's real simple. There's a coax that will connect directly to your TV, and the other one will be from the coax that goes out to your antenna, and the little remote that goes with it. I had some screws and a rubber boot. I didn't use the rubber boot. I didn't have to. But here's the actual antenna itself, and those two things swing out, those two white bars, and expect to spend about, I don't know, 5 or 10 minutes putting on these little metal pieces that you see right there. They don't pack them too well, you know, just pulled them out and threw them. There's the coax. I never even used that because I already had coax running outside. So I'll just keep that for rainy day. The instructions and that little metal bar. So always have a person that likes to read instructions do that. There's my existing Dish Network TV. I wasn't joking when I said cut the cable. So right there, I'm going to use the existing post, and you're going to be able to unmount the dish and use that for your antenna. So here you see the little bar that you saw earlier, and we're lining up those round things, and they basically stay put with a screw, one of the screws that's provided. And there you see me pointing to a hole that lines up. It's real simple, a little Phillips screwdriver, and put in the screws. Part takes about maybe 3 minutes. So I'm going outside right now. I got my nut driver. I got lucky. I found the correct size. That never happens. So take it apart. I sped everything up because it just, you know, who wants to watch me doing that? So getting ready to take it off, and I like to throw it when I take that thing off. That is an expensive way to watch TV. And here is where I'm going to use my existing pole. And real simple. I found some PVC that works. Okay, there I'm putting together the pole mount onto the motor. That big square thing at the base is the motor itself. It's going to rotate the antenna. I heard different things about the length of that motor. I don't see how it can last outside that long. So they're basically getting it ready to put on the PVC. Please don't send any emails about using PVC. I did it just because I was in a hurry. So as I mount that, getting it ready so I can slip the post into that hole and then use the yellow things to tighten it up on the left and right side. It's all pretty easy. See what the next piece is. Okay, there's the PVC. That is 3/4 inch PVC, and it fits in there just fine, real fine. And there's my antenna in action. So that's how it looks. And I use some pretty good black duct tape to fasten it. There's my coax, real simple, just plugs right in, and didn't have to do anything else with it. Set those little deflector type panels up. And I don't think this thing's gonna hold up in the summer heat. I mean, that's, I don't see how it's even possible. Maybe I'll do a follow-up video in about a year and let you know. And that's the motor. We started getting a good signal, and there you can see me getting ready to say goodbye, Dish. Goodbye.